Okay, now the last part. Here is the HL settings. First part is very useful option in case that you want to reach very low power consumption, and it's the option to set all three pins as analog. On some devices, mainly the F devices, are all three pins set as the floating input. These inputs can really increase your consumption. We will look on this during one hands-on, how behave the unconfigured and the floating input pin. Then if you want to be sure that your consumption will be stable and very low, you can set here this option to set all unused pin as analog. This means all these gray pins will be set as an analog input, and in this mode the pins have very low consumption. But be careful, in case that we select this option, then all unused pin will be set also as a analog. Problem is that between these pins is also the JTAG, which is defaultly set into this mode. And if you set these pins like this, then you will lost the contact with your debugger. And you need to use the connect under reset in your IDE, or you need to use the ST-Link utility to erase your microcontroller. Then you not happened that we lost the contact with debugger. Here in the debug, you need here select the SWD or the JTAG, depends which board do you have. And it will reserve for you the JTAG pins. And then you never lost contact with your debugger. But in case that we're not using the set all three pins as an analog, we don't need to care about this. And definitely, I don't want to now test this option. Now, the last part which I have here is the enable the full assert. What this means? The full assert is the macro. It's usually all functions checking the input parameters inside the HL library. Then if we enable this use full assert, then in case that the input parameter is wrong and the macros inside the HL function will detect this, they will go immediately into the assert fault handler. If we open our project, the assert fault handler is usually in main. It's here, and you are notified that something is wrong, some input parameters are out of the ranges inside the assert failed macro. Then you can put here, for example, while or some checking function to check if your function parameter is really okay or really wrong. Okay. I think we can very simple test this. Here, create new option, for example, setting 5, save as setting 6. Okay. I enable the full assert, and now I will generate my project. I will open my project, and now in the application, in the main.c, I have here the assert failed, then I put here my code which will block the complete processor. I will use the while one. Okay. And I can try to force him to go into the assert failed with the simple trick. I here put the HL. The GPIO, we use the same functionality like before, we can use the toggle pin. Okay, the GPIO A, like before, and we use the GPIO, I think not the GPIO pin underscore 5, it was before. Then this will always be okay, because this option exists. Okay, we not now configure the pin, then we will not toggle with our LED. But this is okay. This is more than enough for the testing. If we go to the debug, you now know how to do this, also for the different IDEs. I can here put the paypoint by clicking or double clicking on the left side of this line. And I can run my code. Ah, sorry, it was entering the debugger again. Sorry. I can run my code. It's my breakpoint here. And you can see I never reached this breakpoint because the parameter is okay. All the parameters are okay. But if I here put the input parameter, which is obviously wrong, you can see there is the value. Then it seems I can put here the, for example, the pin 17, because the pin 1 is on the bit 0, pin 2 is on the bit 1, pin 3 is pin 2 is on the bit 2. Then I here put the 01 and I try to create my pin 17, which doesn't exist. I will check what this will do. If I will enter some fault state or not. And you can see the parameter was wrong. I am into the assert failed function. Then this is useful in case that you want to be sure that your input parameter are in the correct range. Okay.